All right, so this video is going to focus on how to find the area of the shaded region. So what we have here is we have an equilateral triangle, and we know that because all sides are equal here. We see 3.8, 3.8, 3.8. So all sides are equal. That means we have an equilateral triangle here. And we want to find the area of the shaded region. So if we notice this side over here that's shaded, we have this triangular center here that is not. So when it comes to this triangular center, we also know all the sides of that, because it says right here what this arrow is pointing to is that each side is 1.6 centimeters. So that means 1.6, 1.6, 1.6 on each side. So the middle piece here is also an equilateral triangle. So what we're going to do here is, this is kind of like a three-part question. What we're going to do at first is we're going to pretend that this middle piece does not exist, and we're going to find the area of this big triangle here. Then part two, we're going to find the area of the middle piece. And part three is we're going to subtract those together. Because if we take our big triangle and we subtract this middle piece here, that's what's going to leave us with the shaded portion, which is what we want. So I have the formula for the area of an equilateral triangle right up here. So that is 0.433a squared, where a is the side of the triangle here. They're all the same. All right, so what we're going to do, step one, find the area of the big triangle. So I'm going to use this formula here, and 0.433 is part of the formula. Otherwise, you might see a variation of this formula that is square root of 3 divided by 4 times a squared. It's the same thing. Otherwise, 0.433 times a squared, so our a, our side of our triangle, for our big triangle here is 3.8, and we need to make sure that we do not forget to square that. So simplifying this further, order of operations tells us that we need to work with the exponent first before we multiply it times the 0.433. And if I multiply that out here, so 3.8 times 3.8 is giving us a 14.44. And we need to drop down that 0.433 in front so that we can wrap up this multiplication here. And when we multiply that together, I am getting 6.252525 and so on. I'm going to leave this to 6.25. And this would be centimeters squared for the entire area here. But we need to pause. We need to find the area of the middle triangle. So we're going to take the same formula, 0.0433, and the side of one of our sides here for the middle one is 1.6. So we would do 1.6 squared. So same thing here. Order of operations tells us to simplify our exponent first. So if we do 1.6 times 1.6, we get 2.56. And we need to multiply that by the point, not 0.044, that is 0.44. So 2.56 times 0.433 is going to give us a 1.11 if we round that to the hundredths. So this is going to be the area of our middle triangle here, our small one. So now what we are going to do here, so we have the area of the big one. We're going to take away the area of the middle piece so that we know the area of our shaded region. So that's just a matter of taking 6.25 minus 1.11. And when we subtract that here, I'm getting 5.14 centimeters squared. So that is going to be the area of this shaded portion here for our triangle.